I'll be telling the story of the prince and the three fates. So once upon a time, there was a kingdom in which a prince was just born. And not only the king and the queen were happy, but the entire kingdom was extremely happy because now they finally have a heir to lead the kingdom in the future. As I said, all of them were extremely happy, but there was one problem. When the prince was born, a fairy appeared out of nowhere, and it told everyone that the future holds a grave danger for the prince either in the form of a dog, or in the form of a crocodile, or in the form of a snake. Everyone was terrified, but the king knew, but the king thought that he could take care of it. So he raised the prince and named him Inaro. He was always accompanied by soldiers or guards wherever he goes. He was taught how to defend himself. He was taught how to run fast. He was taught how to save himself. He was taught how to save others. And he was also educated by great teachers and professors inside the palace. The thing is, he was never allowed to go outside the palace because the king and the queen were very afraid to let him out into the world. So they brought him up only in their palace and didn't let him go outside. And since he was a child, he wanted to go outside and to explore the world. But he was not allowed, and he was aware of the prophecy. He was aware of the dangers that he had, even though he wanted to go out, explore the world, and see what the world has to offer. But his parents, the king and the queen, did not allow him to go outside because they were very worried for him. One day he became a young man, and he saw a dog outside the palace, and he wanted to have the dog as his friend and as his pet. So he asked his father whether he could have the dog, but his father told him that it was a danger. It was one of the dangers in the prophecy, and you shall not have the dog because it might harm you and it might even kill you. We don't know what the prophecy can do to us, so no. But Inaro asked his father very kindly and very sweetly. So the king, he wasn't able to say no, and he allowed him to have a dog. Inaro became very, very happy as he finally has a friend with whom he can play with and talk. Both of them spent a lot of time together. In fact, they spent all their time together. They became very close friends. In a few years, the prince Inaro, he became the king of the kingdom. And everyone agreed, even though he could not come outside and see what's happening. Everyone agreed with the king and believed in Inaro. But Inaro wasn't sure of himself. He went to his father and he said that, "Father, if I cannot explore the world, how am I going to save the world around me? How am I going to save the people around me? I need to go outside and explore the world." So his father granted him the permission, and he went outside the palace to explore the world. Him and his dog, Inaro and his dog, both of them sneaked on a ship, which was set on a voyage across the world. Both of them sneaked upon it, and amidst the voyage, there was a thunderstorm. And in the thunderstorm, the dog fell out of the ship and it was drowning. Inaro saw the dog and he went outside the ship to save the dog. And while he was swimming through the ocean, there was a crocodile which was coming for him from his back. And suddenly the crocodile was scared away because someone shot arrows at the crocodile. When Inaro turns back, he sees that a beautiful princess had saved him from the crocodile by shooting arrows at the crocodile. When he gets on the ship, he thanks her and asks her for a name. She responds by saying that her name is Elena and she is a princess. Inaro was mesmerized by her beauty and her braveness. Both of them liked each other very much. Soon the voyage was completed. And the guards of the kingdom of Princess Elena caught Inaro and his dog. All of them thought that Inaro was a thief, and he came upon the ship to steal from them. But when Inaro told everything about him and his prophecy, all of them understood. And he also told that he wanted to marry Elena, and Elena agreed. So Elena and Inaro decided to fight the snake together. So one day, um, so um, so one day the snake had showed up. Both of them were sleeping, and the snake slowly crawled towards Inaro. But Elena woke up and she observed this. So she already had a plan for this. She took a bowl of milk and some sedative in it, and she kept it near Inaro. So when the snake came near him, the snake drank the milk and it fell asleep. And Elena woke up and she threw the and she ordered the guards to throw the snake far, far away from the kingdom in a swamp. In this way, they have defeated the entire prophecy. And they decided and they led their life happily after. Since that day, they had no problems. And even if they had problems, they figured all of them out, and none of them bothered them too much. So they led a happy life ever after. Thank you.